Hello again, everybody. This is our second video about English arts. So let's go on. As you can see, and probably you check, this study guide has the same information from the previous one. Why is this? Because the topics, they are connected and the idea is to keep practicing. As you can see in this part, the class number is 25 and the review of the class, okay? So it is not necessary in this case to go through the explanation of each one of the topics that we have in this guide, because you already have it in video number one of English. So if you have any doubt, please go to the first video and check the information that I have there, okay? So let's move to the activities in this case. In this point, you already finished the activities on Richmond platform. Remember that you can not only do the activities that I assigned for you, you can go to the Richmond platform and do different activities by your own, to practice by your own about different topics. Remember also that the first bimester we work on Unit 1 and Unit 2. Recuerden que las unidades que trabajamos de Richmond este bimestre fueron la unidad 1 y la unidad 2, por lo cual pueden ingresar, como les comentaba anteriormente, a la plataforma, a hacer trabajo independiente y hacer práctica independiente, okay? Teacher, but what is the meaning or the objective of this study guide? Okay, after practicing in our Richmond platform, it is time for you to keep practice and work on some other activities. This one must be printed and presented after the recess period. The topic that you are going to use were seen in class or during the guide, worksheet number one, ¿ok? Quiere decir que ya no vamos a trabajar en la plataforma de Richmond, ahora vamos a hacer algo escrito, ¿ok? Y los temas que vamos a ver son los que hemos visto en clase o durante la guía de estudio número uno, ¿ok? Again, you have here the same links that I have, and at the end of the guide, you have the activities, ¿ok? Please don't be scared about the activities, they are pretty easy, and you have to read each one to do your best on the activities, okay? So the first one, it is complete the table with the words and expressions below. They are two, you don't need. It means that you have 2, 4, 6, 8 words. Tenemos 8 palabras. Y básicamente lo que tenemos que hacer es clasificarlas. Depende de si es una palabra asociada al éxito o una palabra asociada a un fracaso, okay? This was our first topic, I guess, in our first period, so it is pretty easy for you, okay? Here you have the example, which is booming, and booming is connected with the success, okay? So you have to write down which the other 6 words are depending on the success or failure. Remember that there are 2 words that you don't need, okay? De las 7 palabras restantes, hay 2 que ustedes no deben clasificar, es decir, que no deben aparecer en ningún cuadro, okay? The second activity is pretty easy, which is match the idioms and complete the sentences with them. En algún momento alcanzamos a ver idioms, ¿ok? Recuerden que los idioms no son idiomas, los idioms son expresiones, dichos que nosotros tenemos en cualquier idioma, ¿ok? En este caso tenemos un ejemplo, ¿cierto? Que es el número 1 con la letra C. Bring the house down. Ese tema lo vimos en una de las lecturas que practicamos en clase, la página 140, cuando estaban dos chicas que eran hermanas, que una salía de fiesta, que la otra no, que era el cumpleaños, de pronto se acuerden un poco de eso. Bring the house down. It can be worked in the sentence 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. What is the idea? First, in these lines, okay, let me use the marker to show it. In this line, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, you have to write down the correct idiom. After you have the idioms in these lines, you have to go and move to this activity, okay? To this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one. And you have to write down the idiom that is correct in each sentence. Here we have one example, okay? This one. Gosh, Dios, perdón. When you don't take advantage of an opportunity, miss the boat. When you don't take advantage of an opportunity, cuando no tomamos ventaja o no aprovechamos una oportunidad, ¿qué significa? Miss the boat, se nos fue el barco, okay? Miss the boat is one example for the activity. Okay, that's the thing that you have to do. Okay, continue. The following activities, they are find the word in each box and complete the sentences. They are pretty easy. The idea is that you have to pay attention to the words and find what is the unscrabble word. Let's check the first example. The most basic unit of color in a computer image. Entre todas estas palabras, descubrimos que la palabra era pixel. Esa palabra también la vimos en clase, ¿cierto? A picture that represents a person's mood or feelings. Una imagen que representa la forma o los sentimientos de una persona. ¿Cómo se llamará? La escribimos en este lado, ¿ok? Luego, utilizamos estas mismas palabras en las oraciones de la derecha. Pretty easy, ¿ok? This example or this exercise is exactly the same, okay? Unscrabble the words, then complete the sentences. Vamos a descubrir, ¿cierto? Unscrabble, sorry if I don't remember the name in Spanish. Vamos a ver qué palabras tenemos acá. Cuando las tengamos, las utilizamos en esas oraciones. Si ustedes se dan cuenta, el ejemplo de labradoodle, they are words that we already saw during the activities at school. So they are common for you and they are pretty easy for you to understand it, okay? Then complete the idioms and then complete the sentences with the correct form of the idioms. It's again, la idea, chicos, es practicar vocabulario, que ustedes usen el vocabulario que pronto ya reconocen en la vida real. Once again, is written, sorry. Guys, let me use this one, which is better. Is written in double Dutch. Esa oración me acuerdo muchísimo que la utilizamos en clase y que de pronto se acuerdan un poco de eso. Está escrito en chino, eso está escrito en mandarín, está escrito en doble, ¿sabes? Es como, no lo entiendo. Entonces, ¿cuál es la idea? Descubrir todas estas palabras y una vez las tengamos, las podamos utilizar en las oraciones, ¿ok? Then you have to choose the correct answer. This is only to circle the correct answer. In this one, you have to complete the sentence with the words below. They are for purpose, reason, or result, as we already mentioned. You have to use these ones to complete the six sentences, okay? We can use one word more than once. Yes, you can use it. ¿Pueden utilizar las palabras más de una vez? Claro que sí, las pueden utilizar, no hay ningún inconveniente. The same in here. Complete the sentences with the words appear, seems, and or would. ¿Las podemos utilizar más de una vez? Claro que sí. En esta oración, lo mismo acá. Put the word in order to make distance and sentences. Poner las oraciones en orden. Recuerden que habíamos hablado que la estructura to distance in sentence starts with the passive and reporting verb. It is thought, ¿ok? Luego, ¿cierto? Venimos con una palabrita súper clave que es that. And the rest of the sentence is the clause. Entonces, piensen en este ejemplo para poder completar las demás oraciones, ¿ok? Then we have the match the parts of the sentences. Chicos, acá tenemos un ejercicio de 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let me use this one, which is better for me. Tenemos 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Up to 6. And letter A up to F. Those are the ones that you have to connect, ¿ok? El ejercicio es de forma vertical, no horizontal, ¿ok? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 with A, B, C, D, E, F. Y lo mismo pasa acá. Okay. Let's move to the next one, which is pretty easy for you. You only have to read. Cross out the answers that is wrong. En este caso, chicos, tenemos que tachar, cross out, tachar la respuesta que es o que son incorrectas. En este caso, el primer ejemplo, apparently and may, esas son las palabras que no corresponden a la oración. People who learn languages easily tend to be good listeners. No es apparently, no es may, es tend to, ¿ok? Porque dice that is or are, porque en algunos ejemplos hay una que es mala, que es, no es correcta, o dos, Ok, eso es lo que tienen que hacer. En este caso es rewrite the sentences using clip sentences in such a way that the underlined information is emphasized. Recuerden que utilizamos clip sentences para enfatizar información. Ok, en este caso, I love coffee ice cream. Me gusta el helado de café. What I love is coffee ice cream. Lo que amo, lo que en realidad me gusta, es el helado de café. Ok, so we have to use that structure to emphasize. And that's it. You don't have more exercises. Remember that if you have any question, you can go back to the previous video, or you can go to the guide study number one, or also you can look for information by your own on internet. Or if you have any question, you can write it through the platform and I will answer you any question. Okay? Please, chicos, recuerden por favor darle like al video, suscribirse para poder saber quién está trabajando y quién no, ¿ok? Recuerden que estamos en estos momentos de contingencia para ustedes, para cualquier cosa que necesiten y para cualquier duda, un mensajito por plataforma comunicados y con gusto los atenderemos. Listo, chicos, espero que se encuentren muy bien y que tengan un muy buen día.